plant-based synergistic multinutrient complex assuring total health and longevity. Rejuvalinks.
And your adrenal glands become overactive. And then when it goes down, that's when you crave more. You need to pay that back plus the interest. Later, we're gonna be depleted. Then that's an addiction. No coffee could help anymore. An acidic body is a sick body.
Hi, my name is Denise Milfort. Health enthusiast. I'm here with Dr. Jacob Hoban.
Thank you for having me.
Well, should we get started with the questions? Are
Absolutely,
you ready?
Yes.
Okay, good. Well, let's start with when I first wake up in the morning.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Now, me personally, I have an issue with coffee because when I drink coffee, I get muscle spasms from it and I stay up pretty much all day, all night. Like, it really ruins my sleeping patterns. Mm. So what is that?
So why do you drink it?
Oh, I don't drink it anymore.
Oh.
But I'm curious why that is, why that happens to me. Because a lot of my friends drink coffee, and I want to get into that next, about everyday people waking up and drinking coffee throughout the day. But I just wanted to ask you that question.
Well, basically, coffee is a stimulant,
mm-hmm.
like sugar, like alcohol, like any drugs.
Okay.
And caffeine is one of them. And it just stimulates you and, you know, just supposedly, or actually in actuality, it gives you some awareness or awake, you know, you feel more awake and you feel more energy.
Mm-hmm.
But what it does in the base is that it works on your adrenal glands.
Okay.
And it stimulates your adrenal glands and your adrenal glands become overactive. And every time that you stimulate something, then later you become depleted. In other words, the more you stimulate your adrenal glands by caffeine or other drugs, the more depleted you're going to be. That's why you're going to have a rush and you're going to have a high followed by some down moments.
Okay.
That's why when you have coffee or something sweet in the morning, by late afternoon, about 2 or 3 o'clock, you crash again. And that's when you feel like you want to have another cup of coffee or you want to have some more sweets, mm-hmm. or something to pick you up again.
Exactly.
And that's what happens, because it goes up, and what goes up must come down. And then when it goes down, that's when you crave more. And then, you know, sugar does the same thing.
Yeah.
And alcohol,
sugar, alcohol, caffeine. All of those things fall under the category
drugs.
They act like drugs.
Actually.
Okay.
Yeah. So they give you something that doesn't belong to you,
mm-hmm.
And later on you have to give it back. It's like you borrow money,
mm-hmm.
and like let's say you're broke, God forbid.
So you're broken energy. I wake up in the morning, I'm broke.
So you need to borrow.
Yes.
And then you go and borrow. So you borrow, but you know, you need to pay that back plus the interest. So it's not the way to have energy. And the best way to have energy is to find out what is it that is depleting you of energy.
Okay. Actually, this makes perfect sense. I love this analogy. Mm. I really do. I love the analogy of borrowing money.
Right.
It makes sense. So.
But that's what's happening to the economy today.
Yeah,
the countries that are good at borrowing money, they're the ones that are suffering the most,
mm-hmm.
because we become a consumer community, and we just keep borrowing and we just spend on credit cards and line of credits and all that, but eventually we have to pay both on personal and as a government.
Right.
So the same thing we are doing to our body, we are borrowing energy to stimulate us, and later we're going to be depleted, and we're going to pay that back.
Okay.
Big time.
So, well, I know most people are not experiencing muscle spasms from coffee. I know that I'm a unique case because I ask people all the time, and they don't tell me that they're suffering from muscle spasms when they drink coffee. However, most of my friends, family, drink a lot of coffee.
Right.
So they're waking up, and like you said, they're borrowing energy, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. from drinking coffee so they can have energy throughout the day. They're drinking 4, 5, 6 cups. is it okay to borrow $10, like one cup of coffee?
Well, if you okay. can, well, I like, don't know if to borrow $10 is like a cup of coffee. Maybe a cup of coffee is like borrowing $500.
$500, okay.
Depends on the person. See, for one person, borrowing $10 might not be that much.
Right.
But for another person, might be too much. Okay. It all depends on you. And you know how your adrenal glands are functioning,
mm-hmm.
and you know your whole total health, because not two people are the same.
Very true.
So one person might be okay with one cup of coffee, but if the cup of coffee that person is drinking is to keep him or her awake, then that's an addiction.
Okay.
And then later on, you're going to be more depleted. So after a few years, or maybe after a few months, and after a while, then you need two cups of coffee.
Right.
And then after a while you need three cups. And then four. And then
you get to a point. Like that.
Yeah. And then you get to a point that it becomes, you know, no coffee could help anymore.
Yeah.
And that's the total, you know, that's when, you know, you cannot, you're broke, you have borrowed all the money, and you can't borrow anymore, and no one even lend you money anymore, mm-hmm. and that's when what would
an equivalent of that be in the body? Like your adrenal glands explode or something? Like give me an example. Like what would happen to your adrenal glands? Because you said earlier that coffee and stimulants,
they become fatigue. They become, like, it's called adrenal fatigue.
Fatigue, okay.
Yeah. And the more you stimulate, you know, stress does the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Alcohol, sugar, they all stimulate, and then they turn the adrenal glands to go fatigue.
Okay.
And the funny thing is that all the things that we are talking about also turn the body into acid.
Okay.
And, you know, an acidic body is a sick body. You know, all diseases could come out of the acidic body.
So caffeine, coffee, and all these other stimulants, like you were mentioning, like alcohol,
right.
Red Bulls and stuff like that,
mm-hmm.
all of those things contribute to this acid
Absolutely.
Environment in the body?
Drugs, yeah.
Yeah.
Drugs of all kinds, whether they're over-the-counter drugs, prescription drugs, or street drugs, they all act the same way.
Okay, and they all stimulate acid in the
yes.
body. I got it.
I call them, you know, I call all of these instant gratification.
Yes.
And long-term suffering.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, you somehow get, you know, some kind of gratification from these. You have a piece of cake and you're happy and you feel good and everything. But in the long run, definitely you're going to pay back. And same thing with alcohol and everything else.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, in order for us to be happy or to be calm, or you know, to just relax, and a lot of us are used to use these stimulants or use these drug-like substances.
Yes, people drink coffee every day,
to make
day,
us
Dr.
happy,
Hoban.
Or to yeah, they do
every day.
They do. It has become a norm.
Right.
But norm is not natural.
No, it's not.
Norm is not healthy.
Right, but if people don't drink their coffee, they get headaches.
That's
can't function. So.
That's the addiction.
Why should you quit if you have to go to work and you're going to have a headache all day long?
Well, again, that's the addiction, because the reason you're having headache because you're having a withdrawal. The headache is a withdrawal symptom.
From the coffee.
Absolutely.
Okay.
From the caffeine. It's like heroin. You know, you if you don't get the heroin, that if you're addicted, then you get all kinds of symptoms,
yeah,
not only a headache.
Sick. Exactly.
So it's just a form of an addiction.
Do you suggest everybody go off coffee? Or do you think it's probably better to avoid drinking coffee, like maybe in moderation? What would moderation be for the average person?
Okay, my suggestion for drinking coffee is, if you have to drink coffee,
mm-hmm.
to stay alert and to stay awake, then you shouldn't drink coffee.
Okay.
But
that's why most people drink coffee,
exactly.
Dr. Hoban.
But if you're going out with friends and, you know, you're just having fun and recreationally and occasionally, you want to enjoy a cup of coffee, more power to you. There is nothing wrong with that.
Okay, you're not drinking it because you need to wake up.
But if you drink it and you have to drink it, and if you don't drink it, then you get headaches and you have withdrawal symptoms.